Guys, we're back with Great Dane Shaped Retrieve. So what we've got is a dog that's maybe 2 years old, but lives with, and I'm going to get him out in a second, man, a little chihuahua that's old and that has had an adversarial relationship with since it was a puppy. So you've got to make yourself aware of that when something's that much bigger. But what I'm working on is a shaped retrieve. And so what I've got today, let me do this part. I'm adding the dumbbell. And this is a shape of tree. I'm telling the dog to do everything. If she's doing it, it's her own idea. And if you said, well, how do you get it to do it? Look at it. And then add your sequence. Alright, so I gotta give her 11 place ribbon. And you don't want to hand out too many of them. You really don't want to throw it like that either. But you want them to understand if the left hand knows what the right hand's doing. So my job is to look. Alright, so she's never picked up the dumbbell, but I can try. She might. It would be cute if she did. That was close. And that's all you need if it looks back there again. I think. Your job is not to point. And you do have to guard the basket. You've got to let them know the basket's off limits. If she does that, and that's your role, is just kind of pull your face away. Make them all kind of seem one in the same. But you want to have a sequence. You want to get it in the basket as quick as possible. You're just, that's part of your sequence. And then you're guarding the basket. I'm just looking at it. I'm not telling her to go get it. She's going to turn her head in a minute. Watch. So then my hands pull away. That's my limitation. Thinking about it. So that's 11th place ribbon. She's just kind of resisting the urge to tell them to do it. The dog, if I don't look at it, that's how I got her picking up the water bottle. She saw I wasn't looking, I wasn't paying any attention to her. She might put that other one up. And the eye looks a lot better, Ann. Uh-oh. What do I need is something between the water bottle and the dumbbell. But I let her know, my hand only goes so far. You've got one shot to get it to me. She might do it now, it's just Skylar. She thought about it. She'd like to get the bottle. Packages. All right, I'm going to work on the obedience now, though, but you can see that she's got it delivered in hand, and you've got to just have it, it's a one-pit. They give it to you, and your immediate hands off. There's no sit, wait, stay, there's none of that. So anyway, you guys, what I've got is my... Probably Bridgie, trying to steal my poop. My 280C, which is very loud. Maybe that's what makes it better. It's a stronger pager. And so it's louder. So I would say to a dog, that's going to be fairly loud, especially if it's right by their ear. So... Well, I think she's going to put her feet up on it. She's too big for the platform, though. They need both supervised for her. So this is a dog that will bite at the leash and try not to get the leash on. So your job, Anne, is to make it as... And I know... And what happens when people don't... You know, they only put it on when they go out. The dog does get hyper-excited and tries not to get it on. My job, get it on there as smoothly as possible. And that's how you don't want them to get this motivation. And this is where the trick is to go. I'm gonna step away real fast. I step away real fast. So whenever I pick up the leash, I always go like that. It's ready to take off. So, be very maneuverable. And I think you want to train it like a horse. Yeah, no, I think you do. So I can move her. I can rudder her with this leash. If you don't have any ability or you don't know how to rudder with one of these, you've got to learn how to do it. Because this is where I'm at. You know, she's following the leash. I'm not doing anything. It's a lead line. Look, I can make it low. I can make it turn. I can make it back. I can swing the butt around. Now to get her down, there's my precursor, there's my leg. I think she's not perfectly looking away. And if you have to, Anne, put your foot on there, just a little pressure. Down. What are you doing about living a fish if you don't have any food yet? So I'm picking her up at the table. I'm just going to follow with the leash to pick her up. Well, I'm just feeling her a little. You know, if I have to back her up. And you may have to with one of these. I can back her this way. I can turn her this way. I can pull her forward. I can make her go faster. I can break her. Back up. Go forward. I'm talking with the leash the whole time. And get her to go down. Okay, it's not an accident that she's looking away. Skylar, you're gonna get sleep. I think she's back up. You just don't want to be pulling on one of these. It's just not gonna work out. Let me see if I can put the bottle down by the... Hey, let me go get, let me do this real quick and then I'll get Pete out. Let's see if I can put the bottle down here by the... Alright, so remember, my job is just to look. You're just adding a little distance. Now I'm looking. My job is to look. Even though I can't see it, I'm still looking really hard for it. I think it's there. I think it's there. Give her a hit. Alright, so she should have a hit now. And it's kind of out in the open now. She might go back. By the fact that they understand the task, that they have to put it in your hand, if your hand is farther away, it seems like if you can establish that close, then you can just add, you know, I didn't add distance, I was just trying to put it far away all of a sudden. So... I'm just doing my part on this thing. So it kind of rolled away. And that is kind of why you want to use the dumbbells, because they don't roll away. And they do... They do, if they can't put them upright. I mean, ideally, they're learning to put things up. You know, a certain way without, you know, honestly, you don't want them mouthing at it at all. I'm worried about Skylar, but Skylar picked that thing up. Anyway, that one kind of rolled off. She didn't see it. I can get her another one stuff. And you should be ready to do that. Okay, so she should know that other one's there, and if she sees it now. That was my mistake for putting it on the wrong side. Anyway, guys, I'm going to work on the dumbbell thing. But that's all you need to start out with. Is them, honestly, just, if you can get a 11th place ribbon. Which is, that's what that was. Any interest at all. It's not that important. I mean, I didn't use dumbbell. I only had the dumbbell, but I always use water bottles, just because you've got so many of them. Whatever you use, you want it to be, just thinking about it. Just thinking about it. Uniform objects, I mean, the thing about water bottles, I use fresh ones all the time. Alright, guys, I'm going to go back over to Facebook and do a couple more episodes. Just thinking about going down there, I'm not thinking about that. I'm going to do Daisy in the town. I got Daisy going on the town. In fact, you know what? I'm going to go get Pete out real quick. And I will be right back. There's no correction, though. There's no correction. It's just really, honestly, you have to think of it as, it's just a task. It's very unemotional. You know, unemotional in that we're not invested in these objects at all. And I think that's where people go wrong. You know, if they use their toys and stuff, there's already been seeming investment in the objects from back then, so, that's just not right. But I'm going to work on that. I think I'll be able to get her picking it up, but if not, I would just, you know, it's because if you said, well, okay, you got it picking up, then what, you just start adding a little bit of distance. I mean, you know, making the exercise bigger. Making the exercise bigger, and by either adding more distance, more objects, both of those things, you know, add a jump. A lot of people put a little jump and have them go over and jump. That's not. Because they put up all the jump. All right, guys, I'll be right back. But I think you see, you've got to not use petting as a reward. With one like this, they're so sensitive. If you slap their ribs, rub their head at all, they're gone. And you've got to actively work the build-up food drive because they just naturally don't have any. All right, guys.